Hello everyone, in today's video we are going to discuss about an algorithm that can be used in while converting a given infix expression to a prefix expression. In my previous video we have discussed an algorithm to be used while converting a given infix expression to postfix. Even this algorithm is almost on the same line as the previous algorithm, but with some minor changes. Note that the prefix expression is also called as the Polish expression. So I have written as the algorithm to convert infix to prefix. Some author have the habit of expressing the prefix expression as a Polish. If I say that reverse Polish is nothing but the postfix expression, because the prefix expression is reverse to that of a postfix expression. Some cases even we refer the postfix expression as a reverse Polish. Please note that I can call prefix as Polish expression. If I can call prefix as Polish expression, then the postfix expression can be called as, or can be termed as, reverse Polish. Maybe for the first time I'm using this word Polish and reverse Polish. Hope that doesn't that shouldn't matter to you people, whether we are calling it as a prefix expression or whether we call it as a Polish expression. It shouldn't matter. Now coming back to the algorithm to convert a given infix expression to postfix, to convert a given infix expression to prefix. As we know that prefix is the reverse of postfix expression, so even my first step there, while converting a given infix to postfix expression, we have scanned the expression from left to right, so I'm writing the reverse of it. So the first step would be scan the given expression. Expression here is the infix. Scan the given input infix expression from right to left. That is, start from the end of the infix expression, from end come to beginning. So second step would be, if the scanned symbol is, we know that in case of an infix expression, we may have an operand or we may have an operator, as well as we may have a left and right parenthesis. So we need to take a decision what needs to be done if it is an operand, if it is an operator, or if it is a left and right parenthesis. Note that if the scan symbol is an, first case I will write that if the scan symbol is an operand, what we can do, place it on the prefix expression. Second thing, if the scan symbol is a right parenthesis, if it is a right parenthesis, in case of the algorithm that we have discussed to convert infix to postfix, as we were scanning the expression from left to right, first we will get a left parenthesis. There you might have noted that whenever we encounter a left parenthesis, we were pushing it on to stack. Now, as in this algorithm, we are scanning the algorithm from right to left. So first we are going to encounter the right parenthesis. Note that if the scan symbol is a right parenthesis, we are supposed to push it onto stack. Third thing is, if the scan symbol is a left parenthesis, if the scan symbol is a left parenthesis, pop the content of stack. Right, pop the stack content and place them on prefix until we get a corresponding right parenthesis. Now if you note, this is quite opposite to that what we have done in case of the previous algorithm that was used to convert an infix to postfix. Now fourth step would be, if the scan symbol is not an operand, if it is not a left and a right parenthesis, obviously it needs to be an operator. If the scan symbol is an operator, first thing that you are supposed to do is, if stack is empty, or top of stack is a right parenthesis, what we are supposed to do? Push the operator, push it onto the stack. Here, it meaning the operator. Now, if this condition is not true, else, what we are supposed to do? While precedence of top of stack is greater than or equal to precedence of scanned symbol, pop the stack content and pop the stack content and place them on prefix. And what we are supposed to do with the operator? Push the operator onto the stack. This was my step 2. Step 2 states that if the scan symbol is a right parenthesis, push it onto stack. If the scan symbol is a left parenthesis, pop the content of stack, place them on postfix expression. If it is an operand, directly place it on the prefix expression. If it is an operator, if you are scanning it for the first time, then push the operator onto stack. If not, check the precedence of top of stack and perform the desired operation. Now, step 3. Sometimes what may happen is, after scanning all the characters in the infix expression, some operators might be left out on the stack. Now what you need to do, pop the content of stack until it becomes empty and it needs to be placed on the prefix expression. So that is my step 3, I'll write the step 3. Step 3 would be, until stack becomes empty, pop the stack content and place them on prefix. So this is about the third step. Fourth step, we need an additional step here, because as we are scanning the expression from right to left, we need to reverse the expression. Reverse the prefix expression to get the final result. Hope this is fine. This is about the algorithm to be used in order to convert a given infix expression to prefix. Note that prefix expression sometimes are also referred as the polish expression. Now what we'll do, we'll trace an infix expression, or we'll trace this particular algorithm, and we'll check how exactly it works. Now I'll take a very small example. Example as A plus B star C. We know that the equivalent prefix expression for this is among plus and star. Star has higher precedence. So I should convert B star C to its equivalent prefix. So this will be star BC. Now plus is the operator. Now the equivalent prefix for this is plus A star BC. Now what we'll do, we'll take this as my input. let me assume that, okay, this is my input prefix expression, and we'll see how exactly the algorithm works. So I'll have three columns as similar to that what we have discussed earlier. First one as scan symbol. Next one as stack. And finally, I'll have my prefix expression. So what was the first step? First step was scan the given infix expression from right to left. So in this case, the first scan symbol would be C. Note that if the scan symbol is an operand, we are supposed to place it on the prefix expression. I will place C on the prefix expression. So in this stage, at this stage, my stack is empty. Next scan symbol is after C, it is star. So now if stack is empty, push the operator onto stack. So my stack has a star. Next scan symbol is B. Scan symbol is once again an operand. Place it on the prefix expression. Now it will be CB. And my star content and the content of my stack will be star. Next scan symbol is plus. Is plus. Now what we are supposed to do? Check the precedence of top of stack. Here top of stack is a star, which is having higher precedence when compared to plus. So pop star, place it on the prefix expression and push this plus onto the stack. Now next scan symbol is A. Scan symbol is an operand. So what we are supposed to do? Place it on the prefix expression. Now after A, nothing is there. Okay, A is the last character to be scanned. So go to step 3. Step 3 says that until stack becomes empty, pop the content of stack and place it on the prefix expression. Now there is only one operator, pop it and place it on the prefix expression. Now stack becomes empty. So this is my end of step 3. Note that there was an additional step, step 4, wherein we are supposed to reverse this to get the final result. So on reverse this. I have plus A star B C. Compare this with my earlier one that we have solved directly. So this is the equivalent prefix expression for the infix expression A plus B star C. We'll take one more example. We'll take one more example with a left and right parenthesis. Okay, the same thing, same expression. Okay, let's just have left A plus B within bracket. Now we know that, okay, the expression which is there as a part of parenthesis should be evaluated first. So the equivalent prefix for A plus B now will be plus AB and then star C. Now this is one operand, this is one operand, this is my operator. So the equivalent prefix is star plus AB C. So we'll check whether how exactly the algorithm works. Now take the expression, the input infix expression, scan it from right to left. So first scan symbol is C. So as it is an operand, place it on the prefix expression. At this stage, my stack is empty. Next scan symbol is star. So operator is scanned for the first time. Push it onto stack. Next scan symbol is a right parenthesis. Note that if it was a right parenthesis, it needs to be pushed onto stack. Now, on stack, I have a multiplication symbol and a right parenthesis. Next scan symbol is B. B is an operand, so place it on the prefix expression. Now, my prefix expression will have CB and my stack content will be star and a right parenthesis. Next scan symbol is plus. Next scan symbol is plus. If the scan symbol is the operator and my top of stack is a right parenthesis, we are supposed to push it onto stack. So this is star, a right parenthesis and plus. Next one. Next scan symbol is A. A is an operand. Place it on the prefix expression. Next scan symbol is a left parenthesis. If the scan symbol is a left parenthesis, pop the content of stack, place them on postfix until you get a corresponding right parenthesis. So this will be CBA plus. Now what is left out? I am left out with the multiplication symbol in this tag. Now after left parenthesis, there is nothing. So it is end of step 2. Come to step 3. Step 3 says that until stack becomes empty, pop the content of stack, place it on the prefix expression. Now my prefix expression will be CBA plus star. Now this was end of step 3. There was an additional step wherein we need to reverse this to get the final answer. My final answer would be on reversing star plus ABC. Compare this with this. It matches. Hope this is fine. This is about the algorithm to be used while converting a given infix expression to its equivalent prefix. Thank you.